Hi, my name is Anupriya. Friends, since our childhood, we study so hard. We do all our best. We try to perform good in every field of our study. For what? For setting a good career in our life. Alright, so when the right time comes, we just found a good job for ourselves and we apply for the job. And when your luck is good, you get an interview call and your interview is fixed. Now, the D-Day has come and you have pulled up your socks. So in this session, we will discuss about few mistakes that we commit in a job interview that should be avoided. Alright, so let's have a look towards it. First one, which I think we commit as a mistake, that is not knowing about the company. Alright, you are going to apply for a job, definitely an organization has called you. So this organization or company must be belonging to any particular sector. Alright, suppose if XYZ company has called you, so it will be a finance sector or it will be an IT sector or hospitality sector. So initial information you should have in your mind, that is about the sector you are going to apply for. Next information you should have, basic information about the company you are going to apply for. Alright, it is not important to go in deep. Alright, but if you have a basic information about the company, so definitely it may help you. Now, if you are not a fresher, you already have an experience in your previous organization, so do carry information about that. I just let you know one of my very bad experience, I'll say. I had applied for a job and I went for the interview. I was very much technically sound in all my answers and I have performed well so far as I think. But what happened when the interviewer has asked me about the hierarchy of the company, I was not aware because I didn't research about that and I was answerless. Though I got a job, but I conceded that it was a not good trait I performed. So carrying the information about the previous organization is more important rather than carrying the information about you're going to apply for. Alright, so this point is very important. Next one, incorrect body language. How important it is. If you're not speaking, this speaks everything about you. Right from entering into the cabin of the interviewer till leaving it speaks. Alright, so when you enter in the cabin of your interviewer, keep your spine straight. It means keep your back straight. Then your neck will be straight and there will be a confidence on your face. So the correct body language in the standing posture will speak a lot about your confidence. Next comes when you ask for the you asked to sit on the chair to your interviewer and you got the permission. Alright, so please make sure you sit at the edge of the chair. Don't make yourself comfortable by using its support because you are going to lost everything from your mind. Already you are very much nervous. So it is important if you are sitting at the edge, your back will be straight, your face will be straight, and third important thing that you will be able to maintain a good eye contact with the interviewer. And in the last, when you leave the cabin, don't handshake till you offer. Alright, if the interviewer is offering you handshake, then only go ahead. Otherwise you don't offer the handshake, it is not appropriated. So following the correct body language is also very essential in a job interview. Next comes giving textbook response. You have been asked a question. And in what way are you answering these questions? Suppose I have been asked a question in one of my job interview when I applied for, that was a finance sector, that how will you punch the order on behalf of the clients? When I have been asked this question, suppose if I would have answered the technical information about the particular software which we used to punch the order, so it was not the right information. I just replied that we will punch the order for the client only by filling the forms which have been provided, and when the client will give his confirmation, we'll punch the order. It was just a general reply. Don't follow the same sentences you have by heart from your textbook. Alright, it will show that you are performing in a robotic manner. You will lose your expression. So following the textbook as it is, as you studied, is not the good one. Be spontaneous, be natural, use the simple sentence, is the right one, that will be okay with your answers. Coming to next, criticizing the previous organization. you are here to get a good job, all right? If you have been asked or discussed, if you have not been asked or discussed about your previous organization, don't gossip about your boss, don't speak ill about the organization, don't speak anything wrong about your previous colleagues. Definitely, it is going to show that you are not carrying a good etiquette. Suppose if you are hired, so you will be in the that organization, and further you may be considered that this person is a nature, having a nature speaking wrong about the people. So please don't do that. All right. Coming to next, telling long stories. Once you have been asked a question, you become happy, you become overjoyed. Oh my God, I know the answer. I am going to speak a lot about it. You will pour all your knowledge in that question as you're replying your answer. Don't do that, because once you'll be overjoyed, what you'll do, you'll start relating a lot of stories. You will start relate so many examples about that answer. So keep it brief, concise your answers. Be focused on that. If you know a lot of things about the question that you have been asked, don't go for everything. All right, just keep it short. Then you will be considered that yes, the person is very, very smart. Last one, only aim to impress. During the whole interview, don't perform like you are here only to impress the interviewer. Because if you do this, it will show your impression like you are trying to flatter the interviewer, and it is not a good trait. Alright, so be simple, go easy, be very spontaneous and natural with your answers. Don't be overjoyed or overexcited, or don't try to flatter the interviewer. So in this way, do follow all these tips and avoid committing such mistakes when you go to apply for a job and when you prepare for your interview. Bye.